Welcome. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Welcome. This is Somalia National Television. You're watching the English news program with me, Mohamed Jamil. Here the stories making main headlines. A ceremonial event was held for Somaliland Got Talent program launch. Government officials attended a state funeral held in Hargeisa. Greece deliver economic reform plans as a part of bailout extension. A massively organized ceremonial event was held to launch the Somalia Got Talent program, aired by Somalia National Television at the Ministry of Information, Culture and National Guidance. A massively organized ceremonial event was held to launch the Somalia Got Talent program, which is aired by Somalia National Television and at the Ministry of Information, Culture and National Guidance. The ceremony was attended by officials of the ministry, including the Minister of Information, Culture and National Guidance, Abdullahi Mohamed Dahir Akuse, the Director General, Mohamed Ilmi Adin Ilkaase, the Director of Somalia National Television, Qadir Ali Gass, and other keynote officials. The ceremony was opened by the Director of Somalia National Television, Qadir Ali Gass, who elaborated on the significance of this program to the youth of Somaliland. Qadir also mentioned that this is a huge opportunity for youth to present and show the rest of the world their talents. This is a weekly program aired by Somalia National Television where participants compete for the finals. The results are judged by three judges who qualify to evaluate the performance of the competitors. This is one of the policies of the Ministry of Information to develop and upgrade the performance of every section. The first phase of this program was launched last week to see the feedbacks and the views of the public toward the effectiveness of this program. The next phase of Somaliland Got Talent program will be ongoing for 4 weeks starting from Wednesday. Somaliland Minister of Post and Telecommunication, who also attended the event, welcomed the efforts of Somalia National Television and called it fruitful and inspiring of the youth. Conclusive, the Minister of Information, Culture and National Guidance, Abdullahi Mohamed Dahir Akuse, concluded the event with a gratitude toward the attendees and admired the role of Somalia National Television in the improvement of the different sectors of the ministry. Somaliland Minister of Information, Culture and National Guidance, Abdullahi Mohamed Dahir Akuse, accompanied by other governmental officials, attended a state funeral which took place in Hargeisa. Minister of Information, Culture and National Guidance, accompanied by other government officials, attended a state funeral which took place in Hargeisa. The minister, speaking at the funeral event, sent condolences to the families, friends and loved ones of Abdi Hero, whose funeral has taken place this morning in the Somaliland capital, Hargeisa. Other government officials attending the funeral event prayed Allah to grant the deceased with ample sustenance, peaceful abode in the hereafterlife. You still tuned to the English news program on Somalia National Television, the only Somali speaking channel with an English news program. And now for our international headlines in detail. Greece has sent a list of economic reform plans to International Monetary Fund and European institutions. Greece has sent a list of economic reform plans to the International Monetary Fund and European institution, according to Reuters, citing a source to close to the European Commission. Greece was required to present its plans as a part of condition for extending its bailout program for 4 months in the deal struck on Friday with Eurozone partners. Eurozone finance ministers are expected to discuss the reform plans in the conference called late on Tuesday. Russian President Vladimir Putin says a full war with Ukraine is unlikely. In an interview on Monday to mark a public holiday honoring Russia's armed forces, Putin added that the Minsk agreements must be released. Relations with the southeast of the country in the civilized way and ensure legitimate rights and interests of the people in Donbas, said Putin. Ukraine's military warned it could be not withdraw heavy weapons from the front line until separatists ceased fire. It's believed rebels will begin their pullback now that the public holiday is over. Moscow has been warned for additional sanctions if the unrest spread further into Ukraine. British Prime Minister David Cameron told the UK Parliament that the economic pain will only increase.
Russia must be in no doubt that any attempts by the separatists to expand their territory, whether towards Mariupol or elsewhere, will be met with further significant EU and US sanctions.
That's all the news we have for you tonight. Until next time, assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.